हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ राजेश कुमार एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द समरी ऑफ द चैप्टर पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन डेंसिटी ग्रोथ एंड कंपोजिशन एंड दिस चैप्टर रिलेटेड टू द पार्ट टू ऑफ द क्लास ट्वेल्थ ज्योग्राफी क्लियर पॉइंट. सो टुडे वी आर जस्ट स्टार्टिंग द अ ब्रीफिंग समरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो फर्स्ट वन, व्हाट इज द पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन? सो पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज डिफाइंड एज हाउ द पीपल आर स्पेस्ड ओवर अर्थ सरफेस. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, हाउ द पीपल आर स्पेस्ड ओवर अर्थ सरफेस एंड इट इज ऑलवेज मेजर्ड इन नंबर ऑफ पर्सन्स. क्लियर? पर्सन्स ओनली, इट इज ऑलवेज मेजर्ड इन पर्सन्स. देन स्पेशल पैटर्न्स ऑफ पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इन इंडिया. सो वी कैन क्लासीफाई द स्पेशल पैटर्न ऑफ पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया इन टू थ्री कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट वन हाइएस्ट, सेकेंड वन मीडियम एंड थर्ड वन इज द लोएस्ट. सो फर्स्ट वन हाइएस्ट पॉपुलेशन, हाई पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, सेकेंड वन मीडियम पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड थर्ड वन लो पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो इन द हाई पॉपुलेशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन आर क्लास इंटरवल शुड बी मोर देन 10 करोड़ पर्सन्स. क्लियर? 10 करोड़ persons should be the class interval and the areas or the states that are comes under Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Bihar and West Bengal. So these are the highest population distribution states in our country. Then second one is the medium population distribution. So isme hamari class interval rahegi 5 to 10 crore. Class interval kya rahegi? 5 to 10 crore. Understand? And the main states under this, that is the Andhra Pradesh is there, Madhya Pradesh is there, Kerala is there, and parts Rajasthan is there, Gujarat is there, then Karnataka is there, and Tamil Nadu. So these are the major, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha. So these are the main states where the population is between 5 to 10 crore. Then the last one, that is the low population distribution. So class interval is less than 5 crore and the remaining states come under this category like Sikkim, J&K, Himachal Pradesh and the northeastern part of our country. Clear? The next one is about the census. So all we know that the first census that was started in 1872 by the Britisher people, and the Governor General at that time, which was Mayo, Lord Mayo. So that was the first person during his leadership or during his tenure, the first census of India collected, but that was not a complete census. Then second one, after 1947, so from 1881 is the first complete census, and 1881 to 1941, so there were total 7 census has been conducted by Census of India. Headquarters is at New Delhi. And around in 2011 census, there was only 15th number of census has been calculated and conducted by the Census of India. And in 2021, that will be the next census year. Clear? Then the first incomplete census conducted in our country 1872 by the Lord Mayo, and first complete census 1881 under the leadership of Governor General Lord Ripon. So this is the important question. Then again, next topic, factors affecting population distribution and density. So there are two factors. First one is geographical, second one is non-geographical factor. Under the geographical factor, that are the natural factors are there, and in the non-geographical there is non-natural or the man-made or the human factors are there. So which are the factors? First one is availability of water, good climate, landforms, then temperature is there, rainfall is there, clear, then slope is there, okay, then rivers. So these are fertile soil, these are the geographical factor. And in the non-geographical factors, the first one is the education, good education, employment is there, transportation and communication facility, minerals are there, different types of religion, language, festivals and historical places, government policies are there, minerals, then good production, industrial development, clear, good sanitation conditions. So these are the non-geographical factor. Then next topic, density of population. So it is mainland ratio, and always measure in person per square kilometer, and highest population density in India, that is according to 2011 census, which was that Bihar, and the population density, that is 1104 person per square kilometer, while the lowest population density is in Arunachal Pradesh, and that was 13 person per square kilometer. Important data, so you have to learn this Then second, average density means overall density in our country in 2011 data, that was 382 person per square kilometer. उसके बाद टाइप्स ऑफ पॉपुलेशन डेंसिटी, तो फाइव टाइप्स में थ्री टाइप्स आर देयर, अरिथमेटिक डेंसिटी, फिजियोलॉजिकल डेंसिटी एंड एग्रीकल्चर डेंसिटी. अरिथमेटिक डेंसिटी दैट इज द सिंपल डेंसिटी एंड द फॉर्मूला इज टोटल पॉपुलेशन अपॉन टोटल एरिया. एंड इन द फिजियोलॉजिकल डेंसिटी दैट फॉर्मूला इज टोटल पॉपुलेशन अपॉन नेट कल्टिवेटेड एरिया. एंड इन द एग्रीकल्चर डेंसिटी टोटल एग्रीकल्चर पॉपुलेशन अपॉन नेट कल्टिवेटेड एरिया. देन ग्रोथ ऑफ पॉपुलेशन, सो वट इज द ग्रोथ ऑफ पॉपुलेशन, ग्रोथ मीन चेंज, सो चेंज इन पॉपुलेशन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ ग्रोथ ऑफ पॉपुलेशन एंड इट कैन बी पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव. क्लियर. एंड द मेन मेन एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ, फर्स्ट वन बर्थ रेट, बर्थ, सेकेंड वन डेथ एंड थर्ड वन इज द माइग्रेशन. सो वट इज द बर्थ रेट, सो नंबर ऑफ लाइफ लाइव बर्थ इन अ ईयर पर थाउजेंड ऑफ पीपल और पर थाउजेंड ऑफ पर्सन. एंड वट इज द डेथ रेट, दैट इज नंबर ऑफ डेथ इन अ ईयर पर थाउजेंड ऑफ पीपल इज कॉल्ड एज डेथ रेट. एंड वट इज द माइग्रेशन, सो माइग्रेशन इज द परमानेंट, सेमी परमानेंट शिफ्ट ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम वन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव यूनिट टू अनदर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव यूनिट फॉर अ फिक्स टाइम पीरियड एंड फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर रीजन. क्लियर. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द माइग्रेशन. उसके बाद है 1901 टू 2001 द फेजेज ऑफ पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ. सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू दिस चैप्टर. सो फर्स्ट वन, देर आर टू फोर फोर फेजेज ऑफ पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ. सो फर्स्ट वन, फेज नंबर वन, टू, थ्री एंड फोर. सो इन द फर्स्ट फेज विच रन्स फ्रॉम और स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द पीरियड 1901 टू 1921, एंड इन 1921 द पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट वॉज इन नेगेटिव विच वॉज -0.31%. दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द नेगेटिव ग्रोथ रेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन, पीरियड ऑफ नेगेटिव ग्रोथ रेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. वाई? बिकॉज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड वॉर वन एंड लो हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज एंड वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ एपेडेमिक्स लाइक कोलरा डिजीजेस. उसके बाद बोथ बर्थ रेट एंड डेथ रेट वर वेरी हाई ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द मेजर डेमोग्राफिक डिवाइड ईयर बिकॉज द पॉपुलेशन इज इन द नेगेटिव. एंड द मेन करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस पीरियड आर पुअर हेल्थ कंडीशंस, पुअर मेडिकल सर्विसेज आर देयर, इलिटरेसी इज देयर, इनसफिशियंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ फूड्स एंड अदर बेसिक नीड्स. सो दिस इज द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ फर्स्ट फेज. एंड सेकेंड फेज 1921 टू 1951, एंड द पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट रन्स फ्रॉम -0.31 टू 13.31%. And this one is referred to as the steady population growth period because the population is going to increase during this period from 1921 to 1951. The next important point is the crude birth rate remained high, but there is decrease in the mortality rate, that is the death rate. And what are the correct other characteristics? Better transport and commercial facilities are there. Health condition has been improved. Sanitation and good the standard of education and literacy rate is in increasing way. Then third one is the phase of the third phase, that is phase number three, started from 1951 to 81, and the population growth rate starts from 13.31% to 24.66%, and this period is referred as period of population explosion. Clear. And rapid fall in mortality rate means death rate is very low and birth rate is very high, and improvement living condition and health care. So this one is again the characteristics of the population growth rate for the third period, that is 1951 to 81. Then fourth phase 1981 onwards, then population growth rate starts from 24.66% to 17.64%, and here the population is in declining way, population growth is in declining way. And here low fertility and low mortality means low birth rate and low death rate, and increase, and why the population has been increased during this phase? Because the increase in the mean age of marriage, that 21 years for male and 18 years for female, and education and health condition has been improved. So these are the four important phases of the population growth. Then again important point, regional variation in the population growth, or we can say that spatial distribution of population growth. So first one, areas of high growth rate, areas of high growth rate, and the class interval, that more than 20%, more than 20%. It is very essential to write with the class interval, areas of high population growth rate more than 20%, or kahan kon kon se area mein 20% se jyada growth rate hai. First one is Meghalaya, राजस्थान, उत्तर प्रदेश, बिहार, मध्य प्रदेश, अरुणाचल प्रदेश। एंड इम्पोर्टेंट मैपबर्ग का क्वेश्चन है, वेयर इज द हाईएस्ट पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट इन आर कंट्री? दैट स्टेट इज मेघालय इन 2011 सेंसस। क्लियर। उसके बाद एरियाज ऑफ मीडियम ग्रोथ रेट एंड क्लास इंटरवल क्या है? 10 to 20%। ओके, देन द मेन एरियाज हिमाचल प्रदेश, उत्तराखंड, हरियाणा, पंजाब, सिक्किम, मणिपुर, त्रिपुरा, असम, वेस्ट बंगाल, उड़ीसा, छत्तीसगढ़ एंड आंध्र प्रदेश। क्लियर। उसका थर्ड एरियाज ऑफ लो पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट, सो इन दिस द नागालैंड हैज़ द लोएस्ट पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ रेट इन आर कंट्री, दैट इज -0.47, केरला, गोवा एट्सेट्रा। देन आफ्टर दैट अडोलसेंट पॉपुलेशन, इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एज ग्रुप फॉर द पॉपुलेशन एंड दिस पॉपुलेशन इज कॉल्ड एज द डिटर्मिनेंट्स फॉर द कंट्री फ्यूचर इन नेक्स्ट कमिंग टाइम पीरियड एंड एज ग्रुप फॉर दिस पीरियड दैट इज और फॉर दिस पॉपुलेशन दैट इज 10 to 19 एज ग्रुप इट्स रेफर्ड एज द अडोलसेंट पॉपुलेशन एंड इट इज रिगार्डेड एज द यूथफुल पॉपुलेशन दैट इज यूथ एंड पॉपुलेशन अराउंड इन दिस एज ग्रुप दैट इज अराउंड 22% एंड दिस पॉपुलेशन एज ग्रुप हैज़ द हाई पोटेंशियल्स एंड एट द सेम टाइम पीरियड दे आर वेरी क्वाइट वल्नरेबल एंड नॉट प्रॉपरली गाइडेड एंड नॉट चैनलाइज्ड प्रॉपरली। सो वट आर द मेजर चैलेंजेस विच आर फेस बाय दिस अडोलसेंट एज ग्रुप्स? फर्स्ट वन, लोअर एज मैरिजेस आर द मेन प्रॉब्लम, इलिटरेसी, स्कूल ड्रॉप आउट्स मेनली इन गर्ल इन द रूरल एरियाज, देन लो इनटेक्स ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स, हाई रेट ऑफ मोर्टेलिटी, हाई रेट ऑफ डेथ रेट्स इन द अडोलसेंट एज ग्रुप, देन फिजिकल एंड मेंटल डिसेबिलिटीज, ड्रग एब्यूज एंड एल्कोहलिज्म, कमिटिंग क्राइम्स एंड हाई रेट्स ऑफ HIV एड्स एंड वायरल डिजीजेज। सो दीज आर द मेजर चैलेंजेस ऑफ दिस एज ग्रुप एंड द हाउ वी द कंट्रीज गवर्नमेंट इज रिमूविंग दिस प्रॉब्लम। सो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ आर कंट्री ऑर्गेनाइज अ पॉलिसी, दैट पॉलिसी इज कॉल्ड एज नेशनल यूथ पॉलिसीज इन 2005 एंड अगेन दैट हैज़ बीन redefined in 2005 also. So what are the major objective this national youth policy? First one, overall development of this age group, then increasing the marriages age and youth empowerment should be given and proper responsibilities and make them a good citizen of this country through the education, sports, equality among male and female and proper nutrients should be provided, फ्री एंड कंपल्सरी एजुकेशन एंड आफ्टर दैट प्रॉपर हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज़, साइकेट्रिस्ट एंड गुड मेडिकल हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज शुड बी गिवन लाइक हॉस्पिटल्स, मेडिकल्स एंड न्यू इक्विपमेंट्स, देन इक्वल पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स, देन प्रॉपर एज ऑफ मैरिजेस, क्लियर एंड प्रॉपर एजुकेशन फैसिलिटीज। सो दीज आर द मेजर objectives of national youth policy. Then next one is population composition. So what is the population composition means? When we are classifying the our population on some basis like age, occupation, religion, literacy, sex, language, so that is called as the population composition. And what is the importance of the population composition? Very important question from the board exam point of view. So first one, it gives us the clear-cut information regarding the gender like male, female, caste, different types of caste and literacy rate. What is the literacy rate for male and female? Then development in the fields of education. Education mein kaisi development ho rahi hai? Then health, cultural, political and social development. Then it also shows the economic status of our country like HDI index. Then next is it also gives us the information about the sex ratio, adolescence age group and rural urban composition and how we can sort out the problem of each and every sector which we are classify. The next one composition is the rural urban composition. So in 2011 census, rural population is 68.84% is the rural population and 31.16 is the urban population. Then what is the rural population? Already we have discussed any area where 75% of population engaged in agricultural and population should be less than 5000 persons, population density less than 400 persons, and that area should be comes under gram panchayat. देन व्हाट इज द अर्बन पॉपुलेशन? पॉपुलेशन डेंसिटी शुड बी मोर देन 400 पर्सन पर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. 75% ऑफ द टोटल पॉपुलेशन शुड बी एंगेज विद द सेकेंडरी और टर्शरी सेक्टर एंड टोटल पॉपुलेशन शुड बी मोर देन 5000 पर्सन. क्लियर. एंड हाइएस्ट पॉपुलेशन, हाइएस्ट अर्बन पॉपुलेशन इज इन गोवा, दैट इज 62.1%, एंड लोएस्ट अर्बन पॉपुलेशन इज इन हिमाचल प्रदेश, दैट इज 10.04%. देन हाइएस्ट रूरल पॉपुलेशन इज इन हिमाचल प्रदेश एंड लोएस्ट रूरल पॉपुलेशन इज इन गोवा. देन अर्बनाइजेशन, वट इज़ अर्बनाइजेशन? इट इज़ अ प्रोसेस इन विच पीपल मूव फ्रॉम रूरल एरिया टू अर्बन एरिया फॉर बेटर लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड एंड गुड बेसिक फैसिलिटी ऑफ देयर लाइफ, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अर्बनाइजेशन. वन इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म रिलेटेड टू द अर्बनाइजेशन, दैट इज अर्बनिज्म. सो इट इज अ वे इन विच पीपल अडॉप्ट द कल्चर ऑफ अर्बन एरिया, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अर्बनिज्म. एंड सेकेंड वन इज द सब अर्बनाइजेशन, very important terms of the 21st century. So it is a new trend in 21st century in which people move from the urban areas to the periphery of the urban area. Means yahan pe kya hai, for example this one is the urban area and people are living in this area. So people from the center of the city, they are moving toward the rural areas. Why? Because of the over congestion, high traffic jams, high pollution. And that's why people want to peace and they are moving from the center to the outer part of the city. So that is called as the suburbanization. So in which the people are moving from the center part of the city to the outskirt of the city. And this one is a new trend in 21st century. Clear. And this is also referred as the urban sprawl. And urban sprawl in which the urban area extended from rural agricultural land. And the main problem of the urban sprawl is that is eating the fertile agriculture land. Then next one is the composition, linguistic composition. And in the linguistic composition, the first language is, language group is Austric, and it is spoken over the northeastern part of our country, and the percentage is 1.38%, and its other name is Nishadha. Then next one is the Dravidian, 20% people are using this language, and this is basically belong to the southern part of our country. Then Sino-Tibetan, it is the lowest language group according to the percentage by 0.85%, and it is also known as the Kirata, Jammu Kashmir, Himachal, Uttarakhand and northeastern states of our country. And the highest proportion of the linguistic groups belongs to Indo-European, 73%, which was called as Aryans, and all over our country this language has been spoken out. Then language group, clear. Uske baad important GK point of view se, the division of people on the basis of their language is known as the language composition. Clear. There are total 22 parts in our constitution, 12 schedule are there, and total 22 languages has been given, has been the permission which constitution has given them to utilize in our country for the official as well as the unofficial matters. So there are total 22 languages which are further divided into four parts: Austric, Dravidian, Sino-Tibetan and Indo-European. Clear. After that, religious composition. So what is the definition of the religious composition? When we classify or divide the population on the basis of their religion is called as a religious composition. And the first one is the Hinduism. It is called as a Sanatan Dharma, and percentage is 90%, and highest percentage is found in Himachal Pradesh. Then Muslim, that is basically found in the majority is in Jammu and Kashmir. Then Sikh, 58%, majority in Punjab. Christian, that is Meghalaya mein 75% hain, Meghalaya mein majority mein hai. Buddhism 20%, 27% in Sikkim, and Jainism 1.2% in Maharashtra. And Hinduism is in minority in J&K, and highest decadal growth rate in India, that is in Muslim. Higher growth rate jo hai wo Muslim people ki, that is increasing a very rapid rate. Then working composition of the population. So there are basically three types of workers: main worker, marginal worker and other workers. Clear. So main workers, that is in our country, who are the main workers? Those who engage with the work more than 183 days, marginal less than 183 days, and other than worker, they are engaged with agriculture, secondary or tertiary sector. So both main worker and marginal worker sharing 39.8%, and while 59.2% is shared by other workers. So highest work participation is in that is in the Manipur, and lowest is in the Arunachal Pradesh. clear? So definition I have already told you. So then work participation rate. What is the work participation rate? The proportion of the workers in a population is expressed by the rate, that is called as the work participation rate. I am again repeating, the proportion of workers in a population is expressed by a rate. The proportion of worker is expressed by a rate is called as the work participation rate, and it includes main worker and the marginal worker. So highest work participation is in the Himachal Pradesh, clear, and lowest is in the Uttar Pradesh. So highest kahan pe hai? Himachal Pradesh, lowest is in Uttar Pradesh, and this one is that is the highest occupation structure, highest working population, that is in the Manipur, and lowest is in Arunachal Pradesh, while the work participation is highest in Himachal Pradesh and lowest in Uttar Pradesh. So this is the whole summary of this chapter, and all the terms have been properly discussed and explained to you. I think all of you understand this chapter properly. Thank you so much.